Let us read now from the diary about the image of the merciful Jesus. Its pattern was revealed in the vision St. Faustina had on February 22, 1931, in her convent cell at Plock. In the evening, when I was in my cell, she recorded in the diary, I saw the Lord Jesus, clothed in a white garment. One hand was raised in the gesture of blessing. The other was touching the garment at the breast. From beneath the garment, slightly drawn aside from at breast, there were emanating two large rays, one red, the other pale. After a while, Jesus said to me, Paint an image according to the pattern you see, with the signature, Jesus, I trust in you. I want this image to be solemnly blessed on the first Sunday after Easter. That Sunday is to be the feast of my mercy. For this reason, the content of this image is closely related to the liturgy on that Sunday. On this day, the Church reads the Gospel according to St. John about the risen Christ appearing in the upper room and about the institution of the sacrament of penance in John chapter 20, verses 19 to 29. Consequently, this image represents the Savior risen from the dead, who brings peace to people by means of the forgiveness of sins at the price of his passion and death on the cross. The rays of blood and water that flow from the heart that was pierced by a spear, not visible on the image, and the scars caused by the wounds of crucifixion call to mind the events of Good Friday from John chapter 19, verses 17 to 18, and verses 33 to 37. The image of the merciful Savior, therefore, combines the two gospel events that best bespeak the fullness of God's love for mankind. The two rays are a distinctive feature of this image of Christ. The Lord Jesus, when asked about their meaning, explained, The two rays denote blood and water. The pale ray stands for the water which makes souls righteous. The red ray stands for the blood which is the life of souls. These two rays issued forth from the very depths of my tender mercy when my agonized heart was pierced by a lance on the cross. These rays shield souls from the wrath of my Father. Happy is the one who will dwell in their shelter, for the just hand of God shall not lay hold of him. I desire that the first Sunday after Easter be the feast of mercy. The sacraments of baptism and penance purify the soul, and the Eucharist most abundantly nourishes it. Thus, the two rays signify the holy sacraments and all the graces of the Holy Spirit, whose biblical symbol is water, as well as the new covenant of God with men in the blood of Christ. The image of the merciful Jesus is often called the image of the divine mercy, which is appropriate since it is precisely in Christ's paschal mystery that God's love for humankind was most explicitly revealed. The image not only represents the divine mercy, but also serves as a sign that is to recall the Christian obligation of trusting God and of active love toward neighbor. By Christ's will, the image bears a signature comprised of these words, Jesus, I trust in you. This image, Jesus also declared, is to be a reminder of the demands of my mercy, because even the strongest faith is of no avail without works. To the veneration of the image understood in this way, as relying upon the Christian attitude of trust and mercy, our Lord attached special promises, namely, of eternal salvation, of great progress on the way of Christian perfection, of the grace of a happy death, and of all other possible graces which people will ask of him with trust. By means of this image, I shall be granting many graces to souls, so let every soul have access to it.